What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Clip Point. Today we've got a pretty cool video, but first things first, make sure you like, subscribe, ding the bell, comment down below, and we appreciate it.
Yeah, so we're gonna talk about the best budget steel. So I hope we get some of y'all fired up because,
well that's my
acetone can popping there. So sorry for the background noise. This is my shop. We just want to send you the right direction. And what's interesting about the best budget steel is you start to kind of get into a conversation, well, what is budget steel, right? And I think, was it Blade HQ probably has,
is it? Yeah, they've got some information on it.
Yeah, and they have a really good scale that kind of categorizes them for you. And I would say I agree with their scaling system. It's pretty much spot on.
There's only one variation there that we'll talk about later that is a bit gray, but...
Yeah, probably in that mid-level. You know, a lot of it has to do with heat treat. And the best budget steel that we're going to go with is actually from a classic American brand, and that is Buck. Buck has the best budget steel, and that is because their 420, their basic steel, has such a good heat treat by Paul Bowes that you actually get edge retention, sharpenability, and stainless levels, you know, into kind of mid-gray level. It actually runs with not quite D2, but boy, it is at the very, very top of the budget line. And
it's, what is this steel?
So it's 420 J2, but it's Paul Bowes heat treated 420. And what's really nice is, from a budget standpoint, you can get a pocket clip Buck 112 Slim, and this is less than $30 that you can pick one of these up. Yeah, that's the classic Buck 110. And you can get a budget, I mean, that's a $50 knife, and you're getting, you know, $50-$60. You're getting a big, heavy user knife that is brass, it's classic, looks great, it's old school.
Back pocket knife.
It's the back pocket, it's the GOAT, right? All knives to be measured against that original folding knife. But you can go with a modern. I've obviously, you know, pimped this a little bit. But it's Paul Bowes heat treat, so that means that has great edge retention and easier to sharpen as well for those of you who sharpen your knives. And you can get into a budget knife here. So when you look at all of the budget knives, if you're going American made, for under $30, you can get really good edge retention, a great design, a simple knife, and it's American made.
Yeah, now what would you say would be a comparable kind of runner-up honorable mention type steel?
Yeah, and I don't know, I do have one. So this is a Spartan Blades, and this is their field grade model, and this is the AUS-8A. And this is important, and I think Cold Steel really broke that conversation about AUS-8A. And AUS-8 is comparable to a 420 or a 440 from a metallurgy standpoint, but with the A, what you get is a better heat treat. And so A is the premium. So if you see AUS-8, don't confuse it with AUS-8A. AUS-8A is less likely to chip and has better edge holding, all because of the heat treat.
Right. Well, and you know, especially when we start getting up into some of these more mid, high, super steels, you know, it's worth putting your time in to kind of figure out what steel you need, because so many steels have a different purpose or are better at one thing versus the other.
Yep.
So, you know,
the good news is you've got budget steels that do a good job, and they won't let you down
right.
putting in a day's work.
Well, and here's the thing. There's a lot of budget knives out there, to be honest, that have a mid-grade steel that I would consider a budget knife.
And that's true. I think you start getting into, like with this, you're also, you know, it's $80-$90, and you're getting into the sheath, which we'll do a review on it, which is, you know, higher end. You're getting into the design. It's a Spartan blade, so it's a little more rare. So you start getting into some designer knives with a budget steel, the price goes up, right?
Right.
There are knives a lot less expensive with much better steels than this, but it isn't as cool as this.
So right. It depends on what you want.
There's a lot of factors, but ultimately, the old cold steel AUS-8A, a couple of other brands that did the AUS-8 is desirable, and the Paul Bowes heat tree on these. And you get into some of those really budget steels, right?
So the best budget steel for your notes, if you're keeping notes, is the Buck 420 with the Paul Bowes heat tree.
There's no doubt about it. So there you go. Yep. That's it, guys. Share your opinions down below. Definitely tell us how wrong or how right we are.
For sure.
We want to hear from you and let us know what you think. Is the Paul Bowes heat tree the best budget steel, or you know what? Do you have a different idea? Do you prefer AUS-8? What's your experience? Yeah. Let us know.
And I'll link the Blade HQ kind of steel chart. You know, I'll link it in the description below so you guys can check that out. Yep. And keep an eye out for the mid-grade steel, for the best mid-grade steel. That'll be coming up.
That really video soon. Is coming up.
Yep. So, guys, thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.
Stay sharp.
Stay sharp.